Hi everyone, we're from group 4 for LEX 2047 Poetic Society. Today we're here for our fourth video and we're gonna talk about the third global issue that we choose, which is LGBT plus, and the poem that we choose is Dear Trans Boys by Adrian. This poem is a random, it's not from a prominent writer or whatever, but it's pretty recent. It's from 2018 and we got it from an online blog. So who wants to start first?
First, we need to introduce.
Oh yeah, right. I forgot. Okay. My name. Okay. I'm the group leader. My name is Nur Shazwani. My metric number is 194806.
Hi. My name is Aina Najwa binti Jamal. My metric number is 189044.
Hi. My name is Nik Nur Ashikin binti Wan Anwar Shahbudin, and my metric number is 187483.
Hi, my name is Siti Sarah Widya Saimi and my metric number is 194553.
Hi, my name is Ani Sophie Binti Osman. My metric number is 186713.
Hi, my name is Winston. My metric number is 191338.
Okay, let's start. Now we can start. So, what do you guys think of the poll? It's pretty straightforward, right? It's talking... He doesn't use this person. The poet doesn't use like flowery language.
No, direct.
Like it's very direct. It's a modern type of. Unlike the previous one, the ancestor one, she used a bit of metaphor, like
it's quiet, difficult for us
to wonder a bit.
It's quiet. Because the words are too deep.
Yeah, the words are too deep. Like the carpenter. So now it's. This one is pretty straightforward, like boys who look and sound like me, and you just under, oh, boys who is like him, you know? So, what do you guys think of the poem?
Like, you say, dear trans boy who like to be pretty, who likes the long hair, pink clothes, this is like dating the girls that stuck in the boys' body.
Yeah. Or it's either the other way around. It could be that.
Is it trans boy from girl to boy or?
I think it's from a girl to a boy. That's what you call trans boy.
Wait,
but I think you say like who likes long hair, pink clothes and whatever. Yeah. It doesn't have to be a girl, you know, because I've seen a few men who are men likes long hair, having long hair, like painting their nails. It's just a hobby. So it could be like this, even though he changed to a man, doesn't mean he doesn't like the glitter or whatever.
Girly thing.
Yeah, it could be just his hobby, you know. And I think the whole poem is talking about the insecurities of trans boys. Like the judgmental views or their feelings, because it's new, you know. I just changed into another gender, so I'm still feel like I'm out of place, even though this is my gender, you know. Something like that. So what do you guys think? It's already said. You, what do you think?
Oh, I think that dear trans boys who don't have social media, because you can handle all the hate, and boys who spread knowledge and fight to seek to bring us down. So they want to say that much, like this trans boy can handle all the hate, right? Not all people like this LGBT yet.
Like not everyone can accept that.
Yeah. I can see this trans boy has difficulty during when he or
he
want to go shopping and because in this point
I think it's the fear.
Your trans boy will have deep voices and short hair and pass, but are still afraid to go into the men's section or the department store without a cis male friend. It's normal if we just a normal girl go to the men's section, but for
him is because her appearance is more like men, but she also look like a girl, so yeah. She, so
probably
she also
fear.
Get the gaze for anyone, so that's why he feel afraid or he feel embarrassed.
Embarrassed, yes, that's true.
I think this author want to encourage these trans boys, like
other trans boys,
like encourage them to face the world with all the positive things.
Even though they're facing this kind of things,
but don't bother at the other people.
Yeah. And I think it's like a comfort, like because at the end he said the writer said, you are valid and I love you. I think it's trying to say that, oh, you're not alone. There are other trans boys who are facing these things. You're not alone. We're in this together. So it's quite an accepting. Because it's from another trans boy to another trans boy. So it's a very accepting, positive poem. What do you think?
I think there are some people that have said this is not the right things to do, but he wants to tell that it's okay. It's not only you facing.
I would like to share my experience from this poem. I recite first. There are trans boys who hesitate before going into a public bathroom. Boys who don't go into them at all unless it's a family bathroom, because it just feels so wrong to go into the women's room. From my experience, in my faculty of agriculture, first of all, I sure that he is a male. So I think that so handsome lah.
So handsome.
But then I go into the toilet. Then I finish my business. Then when I want to go out, suddenly the man that I talk
that boy.
He opened the door. Then I was like, faster. Sorry. So I say sorry because of my reaction. But when I think back, I think he is pretty. Yeah, he is pretty too.
People with
she has a bug. So that's why I'm confused. Then when I
it could be a trans
when
girl.
When I see her hanging out with her friend. Her friend is Malay, you know, so they can accept
it. Nowadays, kids are a bit open-minded about this stuff. It's not really accepted yet, but there are some community, like small groups of friends, are a bit more accepting.
Maybe the makcik-makcik.
The makcik bawang.
The makcik bawang.
Bawang. No.
Not agree with you. You know makcik bawang?
It's a term that we use for
older women.
Elder woman who likes to talk gossip. Behind our back. It's like it's actually a reference to some scenes where the makciks, the aunties, are peeling onions. That's why they start calling them makcik bawang. They're peeling onions while gossiping. Okay, we're out of topic. Okay, let's just continue. Anything you want to say?
You say first.
I've known someone, one of my friends. I could say she a trans, but her appearance is like a boy. And when we go we going out to shopping or something, she usually trying to avoid using the public
toilet.
Because
it's quite uncomfortable. Because this Malaysian is not yet accepting. So it's quite hard. I get what you mean.
Like, dear trans boy who pronouns are not cleaning every see her or hers. Like, I actually have this experience also. Like,
everyone has their own experience.
Like when I'm driving, like, going to top up a Touch and Go, is it at the Touch and Go station?
Touch and Go station.
I need to top up. Yeah, I need to top up. But the workers is, when he opened the window, I said, oh, he's a man.
Mm.
So I call it a bang, is it? Like, yeah. Bang, okay, top up. But when he speaks, when he speaks,
it's a girl.
So I'm kind of like awkward, is it? Like,
awkward. I just called this guy a bang.
Oh, yeah, and then after like I'm saying thank you, like I change it again, like thank you, ka. Because I'm quite confused, like what should I call her? Like, if I call him bang, I might think that he will be offended, right?
Hair.
Yeah, he's having short hair.
Yeah, some girls are not actually, they don't really feel like they're male, but yeah, they like
the appearance.
Yeah, they yeah like that. They feel cool, you know. Yeah. They were,
with the outfit.
I was
outfit
like that. I actually used to have the short boy cut hair because I like that stuff, but I don't change my identity. When my friend asked me, because they're a bit open minded, right? They asked me, are you pronounced a she or a he? I said, I directly said, yes, I'm a she. So they still call me a girl. Because I am still a girl. It's just that I like wearing
your outfit.
Yeah, it's just for aesthetic things, you know. But there are girls who do feel like, oh, I'm a boy inside. I want to be a boy. Like in the true sense of a boy. That's another problem lah. It's another issue. So it's a different issue actually. And then there are some boys who like dresses, but yeah, doesn't mean
like
they're
makeup.
Yeah,
Bratman.
Yeah. It's like it's not like they're gay. They're not gay. They're not gay at all. And they don't feel like they're women. Yeah. Also, but it's just like they like pretty things. It's hobby. Yeah. It's just a hobby. Some people are a bit judgmental, especially our society. They just don't. Cannot accept that. Oh, you cannot have this as a hobby. It's for girls. So yeah, that kind of things.
But our society doesn't agree.
Yeah.
Our today, makeup artist also
boys. Some boys makeup better than I do.
So because they like makeup, but they have the skills.
Yeah. Right. They I think it's just that they like pretty things. Yeah. Right? They like seeing pretty things. It's an art. Mm. Consider an art. It's like you're drawing.
Yeah.
Drawing on people's faces. Yeah. It's just a hobby.
Yeah. But yeah.
Yeah.
but most of them, yeah. Yeah, you know, right?
Yeah. Most of them are.
Yeah. Like, sometimes you might say it was a hobby, is it? But after a long time, they quite enjoy it. But yeah,
yeah.
They might change it into. Mm.
It depends.
Because if he like, I mean like something makeup like that, I mean the environment will be, the friends will also the same like that, because they might get, how to say that?
Influence,
yeah. Long time, like take a long time, it slowly changes, slowly changing.
And people's surrounding, the environment.
I have to disagree though, because I've seen I've known some makeup people who make up a man, but he end up marrying he's straight.
Oh, yeah.
He end up marrying a girl.
Rizwan Huzaini. How about that? He's a man, fashion icon.
Yeah, he's a fashion icon, but he marries a girl. He's straight.
Yeah.
So but after marriage, he also changed his appearance. Like his.
Alright.
So I think that's a wrap. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
You got advertisement.
Yeah,
I got advertisement there.